Swinton starts us off.
Talking about right now. Frager trying to put that ball away. She was so successful last night hitting over 500, but tonight they seem to have a beat on where she wants to go.
Van Winden going cross court, finding that angle.
I know, Sam, you asked me what UCLA has to do. You know, Frager and Felix in the middle really have to establish themselves. And then Bushler and Anderson are really going to have to play spectacular. And tough serving, I was going to say next, from that back
yeah,
line.
Sure you were.
On point, you saw it right there by Tori Van Winden. And there is the stylish one, I like to call him.
All right, look at
Mike Seeley.
Look at Mike Seeley.
Yeah. Everything's matching.
Unruffled. It's the best sleeve folder I've ever seen.
I think his watch face might even complement the socks and the tie.
I would say those socks were Carolina blue, but I would be wrong. North Carolina, who UCLA beat last night. You're right, Dane. There's the watch.
Yeah. I'm not going to get into that in between your UNC alma mater and UCLA, but that is definitely UCLA blue.
Is his personality as a coach like it was as a player? I know you played against him.
Yeah, absolutely. He's such an even-keeled guy and such a class act. And most importantly, in what you need as you're coaching at the college level or any level, is an even keel. And that's what he has. He's never going to get too high. He's never going to get too low. Oh, that was something that you don't see very often. Rosada right there could not get out of the way of the tracer from Jordan Anderson, and it just looks like a heat seeker.
Wow.
Right off her shoulder.
Ace for Anderson. And the side out for Minnesota, though, as Paige Stapp restores order for the Golden Gophers. I know Mike Seeley was hoping there'd be a mutiny within the McCutcheon household, as Hugh McCutcheon's wife, Wiz, was one of UCLA's all-time greats and a U.S. Olympian.
For Minnesota, they are game planning for the tip. You see Hart come over, dig the ball, and then Seliger Swinton goes to her favorite target, Will Hyde, coming out of the back row.
Big Ten setter of the year to the Big Ten player of the year.
See that turn right there by Seliger Swinton. Now, if you're an up-and-coming player, you want to take note there. Seliger Swinton did a complete 180, turned and faced exactly where she wanted to be. Look at that turn, face. You can't really teach it any better than that. Perfect execution, Seliger Swinton.
Minnesota has won the last 4 points to lead 6-4. A double contact called against UCLA, point Minnesota. Straight points now for the Golden Gophers. We'll see her run around the building again.
She's about to.
She will if they win. Frager gets the kill out of the middle for the Bruins. Frager, first team all Pac-12 performer this year and also on the Pac-12 all academic team.
Really like Frager's game. She kind of goes about her business in the middle. Hits a really solid percentage last night, kind of quietly putting up 500 numbers. And finally, UCLA gets a stuff block. That time, Kyra Rogers up, and she's bringing a lot of emotion with it. So it's been a long time coming for a block from UCLA, and maybe that will start to really maybe be contagious and the other players getting involved. First team All-American last year. They both have incredible grade point averages. Paige Staff has a 3.88 GPA. We're in the School of Management here as a marketing major, and Hannah has a 3.47 GPA in that same program. They're both set to graduate this month.
Similar to the start of this match when UCLA went on a 16-0 run.
UCLA has to do. Try to take this crowd out of it. Play well. Limit those spectacular plays by the Golden Gophers. But it's not an easy task. No one's been able to do it here on their home court in the last 35 matches.
Rohide picks up her 13th kill. Well, she'll take it. Felix will win that point for the Bruins. Chandler coming in to serve for UCLA.
UCLA's got so much continuity out there. Chandler serving the ball right now. Riley Bushler and Prager, you know, they all played on the same club team. They've been playing together, Sam, since they were 13 years old. So there's a lot of chemistry out there. And at times, you really see it click.
Well, the same can be said of Minnesota, Dana. 10 of their players on the Golden Gopher roster from the state of Minnesota. And of those 10, 8 of them played in the same club program.
Yeah, I think it translates. And I think that's a big decision when one player goes to a school, you kind of follow suit. And you see these interesting combinations of players that have played since they were 13, 12 years of age.
Out of the middle, Frager gets the kill. She was error-free last night with 11 kills. And Frager, one error tonight, but that's her sixth kill. UCLA in the midst of a 6-1 run, and we are tied here in the third set.
Well, you only have a finite amount of time. You've got to get it all on the air right there. They knew it.
UCLA must win this set to keep its season alive.
Sacrificing her body and then the emotional fire. That's one of those plays that can really turn the tide.
She was the beneficiary of Paige Tapp being in the way of that ball because Tapp's body ricocheted over the net after the effort from Rosado. And Anderson tooling the block. Point UCLA. You can feel the intensity of this third set as UCLA knows it's all over if they don't win this set.
Got a lot of pressure on the UCLA side. And in that situation, you want to make it happen right now. You want to make it happen now and not at 20-21. You have to start to play with a sense of urgency as if it were match point.
The quick set and the quick finish. Tied at 16. Will Hike will go back to serve. 29 aces this year. Awarded to Minnesota. Had to wait on that one to see because the linesman and the up judge looked at each other. No call was made.
There it is. It's very difficult to tell if it hit that right hand. And the challenge is not in effect. But I'll tell you what, it pumped up Riley Bushler, who absolutely crushed that one.
Now that is the appropriate way to respond to a call you don't agree with.
That's one of the best hits I've seen out of her. Just fierce.
Some anger in that swing.
Yeah, very aggressive. That was awesome.
And another one. We did not see much of Rogers last night, but she has made an impression in this match tonight, joining Bushler up there on the front line.
Yeah,
number two, Kyra Rogers, has really changed the dynamic at the net for UCLA. Paige Tapp sides out for the Golden Gophers. We're tied at 18. UCLA has had four blocks in this set, Dane. I want to give the Bruins a little credit for their block. We're talking about how the Golden Gophers were dominating that stat.
Well, I'll tell you what, and that's what I was just saying. Kyra Rogers came in and changed the dynamic. She had a couple right off the bat, and it's been a great substitution. It's been a great substitution for Mike Seeley putting in Kyra Rogers, and it's been a difference maker.
That was touched by the Bruins, Point, Minnesota. That's Hannah Tapp who got it. Shaw is in to serve. The Golden Gophers up one.
Looked like someone all over the net missed there.
That's wide. Point UCLA. Minnesota 5 points from the national semifinals, and UCLA 5 points from extending this match.
Set has been an absolute battle, what we expected.
There's the creativity of the freshman Alexis Hart.
There's a nice set to Hart and showing her athleticism with a tip shot of her own.
Atmosphere, Dave. Wow.
Selleck, and Swenson is so smart. She knows exactly when to take charge and to dump that ball. Never does it too often. Has so many weapons, but her placement, position, her hand strength, all on point, and it's showing tonight.
Minnesota on the verge of their second straight national semifinal. The winner to face Stanford next Thursday in Columbus.
And Minnesota just really putting everything together. Offense, defense, owning the net. And Will Knight with 14 kills. 48 attempts. She's hitting 208. But, you know, Minnesota is showing why they have been ranked in the top four for so long. They're the number one ranked team right now in the country, and they're out there, and they seem to have something to prove on every single point.
Well, the NCAA Women's Volleyball Championship coverage will continue with the national semifinals Thursday, December 15th, 7 Eastern on ESPN2. For more information, go to NCAA.com, your home for all 90 NCAA championships. And we have one more spot yet to claim, and the next point may put Minnesota next to Stanford. Winner of this match faces Stanford Thursday night at 7 Eastern on ESPN2. Texas surviving today, getting through their regional, and will face Nebraska. Nebraska almost did not make it as well as they faced quite a battle against Penn State yesterday. It has been a dramatic couple of days at the regional level in the NCAA Women's Volleyball Tournament. May end here. We may have our four semifinalists at the conclusion of this next point. It is match point, Minnesota. UCLA stays alive. Anderson extends the match. It remains match point for Minnesota, however.
Anderson has been doing that all year long. Facing one way, cracking the ball the other direction.
Have booked their spot in the national semifinals.